today is a different type of video today. I'm actually at the cemetery, and I'm actually going to see my father. But today, I really want you guys to know a little different side of me today. We're at the graveyard. We're at the cemetery. This is where my dad is buried. This is like very sensitive to me, very emotional. Like, it just happened like a couple of years ago, it feels like. It's still fresh to me. I usually don't really talk too much about him because that's very much like a real emotional part to me. So I'm gonna let you guys just experience with me one of my visits that I have today. So stay tuned and, you know, just send out prayers and love and support. That's all I want out of this video. Most definitely. It's still a toll on me, like a very, very big toll on me. So I love you guys. And
how many years today?
Yeah, today actually is the day he passed away. 2013, February the 5th, 2013 is when he passed away. So it's very much hitting like hard. So it's been almost 8 years. And he had a very long span of life. My parents, they're very much older than most parents. So, I am going to show you his tombstone and whatnot. So, he is older. He was also in World War II. He was in World War II. He's a veteran. So, he was always very sweet, humble, you know, like, a family man. Him and my mom taught me how to love, like, the full extent of love and loving life and loving people and caring for people. He was an amazing dad to me. He gave me the world, basically. He's been there for me. He's been there for his whole family. He loves to be to himself. I used to love making him laugh and smile. And all in all, he always accepted me for me. He knew that I like women. He did not care. He always used to be like, baby, where your girlfriend at? So, you know, he had a lot of personality and a lot of life to him. So, it just really, really much, like, it's killing me right now that I'm here and not able to talk to him. And a message that I really want y'all to understand and know. I know a lot of people go through things with their families. I know people don't have the best relationships with their parents. And, you know, it's a lot of things. You know what I'm saying? But just know that you only have two parents. You know, whether they're in your life or not, you have two parents. Enjoy them. You love them. You embrace them. You take care of them. If they get you mad, just walk away. Find another day to talk to them, because they also hold a special place in your heart. You understand? My mom is on one side and my dad is on one side of my body. It's half and half. When he left, half of my soul, half of it's gone. You know what I'm saying? Like, you really feel that, and that kills you every single day when you're not able to talk to your parents, when you're not able to tell them you love them, or hey, how you doing, or what you doing, or let's go out, or whatever the case may be. Don't take that for granted, because you're gonna be sitting here like me at a cemetery wishing that you shoulda, coulda, woulda. You know what I'm saying? I'm not saying that I wish I shoulda, coulda, woulda, but it hurts. It hurts bad that you cannot talk to them. You can't pick up the phone. You can't pull up on them. They can't see their grandchildren. They can't you know what I'm saying? Like, be in your life, go visit you, give you advice, be there when you need them, you know what I'm saying? So cherish your parents, for real, because you really will regret that, I'm telling you. Cherish them, love them. If you gotta love them from a distance, just always keep them in mind and in heart, okay? But I'm about to go up here and I'm about to go see him. So you guys stay tuned. How you doing, Mr. Hicks? How you doing? I miss you. I haven't brought you flowers in a while, though. So I'm about to set you up real fast.
This right here makes your heart beat out your chest. Like, seeing this, like, you know it's real.
Like his tombstone?
Yeah. Can't keep asking why. Because God took you. He took you away. And I know he wasn't ready. He wasn't ready. Kept saying he wasn't ready. And he was tired. He was sick. he kept like ripping the IVs and stuff out his arms. I was the only one like really kept him calm in there, apart from cussing out the nurses. But like in my family, like when you know that they about to get up out of here, they stop eating. They stop eating and stop taking medicine. And it's a lot. And you started to do that. And these memories and visions that's like going through my head are like the last times I had with him. I wasn't ready for him to leave. I used to could talk to him about anything and everything I could. Don't understand that, like, when you lose a parent, like, that's a whole different type of love. Like, it make you go crazy. Like, I lost my mind. I went psycho. I went ballistics. Like, I went crazy. It's like, what am I gonna do without you? And I'm not ready to go through that again.
It's so peaceful.
It is. He died at 3:30. And it's 4:27 right now. And the type of connection that I have, I felt him. I fell and dropped to my knees even before I got the call. A lot of people be blessed to have their parents. To see, and I used to have like my old friends and stuff that I used to have, they'll talk to their parents crazy or be like, I hate you, or trying to fight them and stuff. Like, I feel some type of way, because no matter how mad your parents get you, let's say if you walked away from that and you got a call saying something happened to them, you gonna wish you never done that, or wish you never went to that, like, went to that route.
Jump out the rave, roof full of stars. Don't care about your friends, cause I know they all hate them. They mad I drip you down, girl, I gave you too much flavor. Chanel, I wiped you down, fit your bags up with paint. Said that you gon' hold me down, then everything is paid for. Dangerously in love.